machine. And it's funded by the deep pocket interests that want health care to stay just like it is, because they're making money on it. They're making money on it. So our voices today that echo here in the streets of Atlanta and across Georgia, joining with voices all across this country, saying we want health reform now, we want a public option as a pathway to covering every person in this country. Health care is not a privilege, it is a right. Health care is a right. Councilmember Joyce Shepherd, right here in Atlanta, is bringing a resolution endorsing public option, profound and meaningful health care reform in Washington. That will be voted on by our city council next week. She sends her greetings today. She's out on her campaign trail. She will be standing tall for us, and we want every city council person to cast a vote in favor of the public option health care now. We want every Atlanta city council person on the line. Get on the line. Where do you stand? Your vote in next Tuesday. Atlanta City Council, call your city council person. We want to send a strong message. Our mayor, Shirley Franklin, has signed on to that. I come today to say to you, while we won that election November 3rd of last year, the battle continues. The struggle goes on. We all know that the right wing, that the Republican Party spokespeople have said it on the record. They've said it on the record. If we block Obama's health reform, it'll be his Waterloo. They want to take down the president that we elected last November. That's what this is about. That's right. They want to pull the plug on meaningful health reform, pass a bunch of sausage that doesn't mean anything, that means more people die unnecessarily, more people get their health care in the emergency room instead of with a primary care provider. That's what they want to do. They want to protect those who are profiting off of a broken health care system. And it is up to us to send a message that will not happen as long as we have breath in our bodies. We have to get out and we have to talk, preach, walk, knock on doors, get on the telephones, send the message, Johnny Isaacson, you're our senator. We want health reform, and we want it now, and you've got a vote to make in Washington. You've got a vote to make in Washington. And we understand that if you don't put a public option in this bill, it is meaningless. And we understand that the Progressive Caucus in the U.S. Congress has already said we won't vote for a bill that does not have a public option. We won't vote for it. And we want our Democratic congressman, call the roll. Call the roll, our Georgia Democratic congressman. We want you on the right side, following the vote of John Lewis and Hank Johnson, following the vote in the House and the Senate for a public option.
Yes.
The women of WAND are here today joining their voices. Women's Action for New Directions. Women's Action for New Directions. We know that women set the health care agenda in their household. We didn't make it that way. We didn't wish it that way, but that's just the way it is. That's just the way it is. The women in the house make the men go to the doctor, don't they? They say, let's get out here and find some health insurance. Lord, help us if we can. And so voices of women brought to this table are critical in this debate. We're raising the next generation. We birth a generation. We go and get more health care and need more health care because of the role we play in producing the next generation. And bringing women's voices loud and clear to this debate is critical and important. We know they want to block women on every hand. They want to dictate what we can do with our bodies. I don't think so. No. No, not in this day. You know, Dr. Larry says we've walked too long. We struggle too hard. We've seen many fall in this battle for democracy. This is a battle for democracy. This is a battle to not let the right wings take over the political debate in this country and set the political agenda. They were voted out of office. That's right. They were voted out of office. And there's some more of them going to get voted out of office. Don't let up a minute. Don't let up a minute. And in the name of the work, the life's work of Ted Kennedy, who spoke and meaningfully and took action on behalf of the poor, took action to try to save and strengthen the safety net, took action on behalf of health care. We pledge today to to challenge every vote we can touch in Congress. Do not come home without a health care reform. Do not come home without a public option. Do not